Today, guys, I'm going to show you how you can fully publish, create, and edit Roblox games on your phone on mobile. So the very first thing you're going to do is if you are on mobile, you're going to want to go ahead and join this game called Studio Lite. All right, so as you guys can see, we are now joining the game. And if you've ever done this before, you can go ahead and follow the tutorial. But in my case, I'm not going to. And I'm going to go ahead and just create a little basic game. I'm going to import a couple parts just to show you guys how this works. Now, this is a lot harder on mobile, and you're going to have to figure out the controls. It can be a little difficult, but I'm going to go ahead and just import some stuff. You can also use the toolbox as well. So I'm going to go ahead and import this thing. And as you can see, it just went ahead and imported right here. Scale it if I want. You can do pretty much whatever you want to it. But now, once you've made your game, by the way, there's tons of other stuff you can do. Like you can create scripts just like Roblox Studio and do tons more stuff. This is just a basic rundown. I just want to show you how to get the game out, publish it, and all that stuff. But you can follow tons of tutorials on YouTube for how to script and code your game. But this is really important here, what you need to do in a second. So I'm going to go ahead and click File, and then I'm going to click Save, and then I'm going to click Save As, and then I'm going to type in my new game right here. So I'm going to just call it, and then I'm going to go ahead and click on publish. I'm going to click save, and this is not going to publish it to Roblox quite yet. So once you're on this screen, you can go ahead and X out of Roblox real quick. You need to go back over to Google or Safari or however you were on the Roblox website, and you need to go ahead and click on this create button right here. Now, if you don't already have a game, when you scroll down here, an experience, you need to go ahead and create one and make sure that you set it to public. So for example, this game called Would You Rather Test, go ahead on that little three buttons and I can click make public. So now it's a public game that people can play. And the next thing you need to do, so in my case, I'm going to actually just go ahead and publish that thing that I created in Studio Lite to this game right here called Would You Rather Test, because I don't even know what this is. So what you need to do after you've made your game public that you want to work on, so in my case, it's going to be Would You Rather Test. You're going to want to go ahead and you're going to go ahead and click on this three buttons right here. And then you're going to want to go ahead and click on Open Cloud. And then you're going to click on API Key. So as you can see, I already have an active API key. And that was just for a test to make sure that this actually worked. But I'm going to go ahead and click Create API Key if you have it. You can name your API key whatever you want. Now, the next thing you want to do is select API system. Okay, so then you guys want to do is type in universe places. So go ahead, click on that. Click add API system. Then we're going to want to search for an experience. So my other one was called Would You Rather Test. And go ahead and select Would You Rather Test. And then go ahead and click add experience. Then where it says select operations you want, go ahead and make sure it's selected on right. And then when it asks for your IP address, go ahead and type in the default Roblox one, which is just 0.0.0.0/0 add IP address, and it's going to go ahead and add that. You can make your key expire at a certain date if you would like, but now go ahead and click save and generate key, and then click copy key to clipboard. Now we're going to go ahead back over into Roblox, and we're going to go ahead and join this Studio Lite yet again. All right, so now that we're in Studio Lite, we're going to go ahead and load up our game. So this was the one that I saved a second ago, and I just loaded it up, and now we're going to click on file, save here, and then we're going to click on publish, save. And while it's publishing, in a second, a little box should come up with the thing that says API key. So first, we're going to select the game that we want. So Would You Rather Test is the one we just made the API key for. So remember, you need the API key for each specific game. So if you were to try to do this on another one, you need to make a new API key. So I'm going to go ahead and paste this. So you may have to actually turn your phone vertical for some reason, but then you're going to go ahead and click paste, because before it wasn't letting me. Then select off of that, and then go ahead and click publish. And as you can see down here in the output, it's publishing, and it's explaining all the stuff that it's doing. It did just teleport us to our Would You Rather Test. And as you can see, we're now in an actual game called Would You Rather Test, and it has the stuff that we imported in Roblox Studio, and this is our game. Yeah, and this is our game. As you can see, I have the builder icon, which means it is my game. So yeah, this is a really cool way to start developing Roblox games on mobile. If you guys need any help, make sure to comment down below, and I will see you guys in the next video.